go, huh?
Hmm. Oh, yeah.
Oh. Why is it not killing me?
Was that us or the station phone?
I guess it's the station
phone. No. Mm-hmm. I hear it. Well, this is 90s retro.
I know, but what are the chances of two of my songs playing? I can't hear my drink, I ain't gonna have nothing for the show.
Did you know what comes after the show? Oh, that's
what'd you get for yourself? And Jolly Rancher. Yeah, you never got me one?
I didn't know you wanted one.
I always want a Jolly Rancher. It's okay. It's a Eureka cup.
All right, 60 seconds.
Recording. Why does it look weird?
I don't know, Amber.
The views expressed on this program are not necessarily the views of Lexington Community Radio or its board of directors. The views expressed are solely those of the programmers.
You are listening to Off the Cuff. Now, here's your host, Adam Banks.
Everything's good. Yeah, I was just wondering because it looks so big, like the. Oh, welcome everybody to Off the Cuff. I am Adam Banks coming at you live from Lexington, Kentucky. Thank you for listening to the show and thank you for tuning in to WLXU 93.9 FM. In addition to listening to us on the radio, you can check out our Facebook live stream at Off the Cuff with Adam Banks, or you can download the Radio Lex app to listen to us anywhere in the entire world or stream the show live on the web at radiolex.us. Amber Turner and I are both broadcasting from the Deborah Hensley Studios here at Radio Lex on North Limestone. Amber, it is June the 30th, 2022, 4:01 to be exact. We started the show on June 1st of this month. We did a broadcast. Oh, we started off June, and now we are doing a broadcast on the last day of June, June the 30th.
Well, what better way to start the month with us? What better way to end the month?
I don't think we've ever done that before, have we?
Well, there's always a first time for everything.
There is, but this will be kind of our 4th of July show, because next week when we are in the studio, 4th of July will have already passed. Mm-hmm. Do you have any 4th of July plans? I always feel like there's pressure to have 4th of July plans, don't you?
There is. There's way too much pressure. No, I'm going to hang out at the house.
Not even do fireworks or anything like that?
No, you know, we have the dogs, and dogs really do not like fireworks. Like, right. That is not like a myth, a made-up thing people say. They really don't.
Yeah, I never really did see the appeal in fireworks. They're pretty to look at, but after the first couple, I'm like,
I like sparklers.
Sparklers are fun.
Yeah, those are fun. Write your name.
Absolutely. And the kind of those little things that you can throw on the ground and they pop.
Puppets. Yeah, puppets. And,
but you always got that a-ho who will always throw them at your ankles.
Wally.
Yeah. Does he do that?
Yes.
But I hope everybody has a safe 4th of July weekend. This weekend is the weekend to go out and celebrate it. And it being off the cuff, Amber, how about some 4th of July fun facts for the audience?
Hey, there we go.
The Declaration of Independence was not signed on July the 4th, 1776, like most people think.
Yeah.
That's actually the day it was formally adopted by the Continental Congress, but it wasn't signed by most signatories until August.
Well.
So why are we celebrating it a month earlier?
Well, it's the day we said this is for real.
Americans typically eat 150 million hot dogs on Independence Day.
I can get down with that.
That's a lot of wieners. Three presidents have died on July the 4th. Thomas Jefferson, John Adams, and James Monroe.
Oh.
That's very poetic, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
To be the president of the United States and die on Independence Day.
Woo.
John Adams. President John Adams, yeah, believed that American independence should be celebrated on July the 2nd, and that's the actual day the Continental Congress voted for independence in 1776. So, July 4th, nobody can agree when the actual day is that needs to be celebrated.
Well, it's looking like July 3rd might be the best one, right in the middle.
Well, annoyed that Independence Day was celebrated on July the 2nd, Adams, or wasn't celebrated on July the 2nd, John Adams reportedly turned down invitations to July 4th celebrations throughout his life.
Oh, that would be, to know that you have capability of inviting a president and they say thanks but no thanks, that would sting a little.
Massachusetts became the first state to make the 4th of July an official state holiday in 1781.
Oh, what better place?
President Zachary Taylor died in 1850 after eating spoiled fruit at a 4th of July celebration.
Ooh.
Also very poetic. The famed Macy's Fireworks Show in New York City uses more than 75,000 fireworks shells, and it costs about $6 million.
Goodness not.
Fireworks are expensive.
$1 million on fireworks?
$6 million.
Oh, goodness.
That's expensive. Though, if you go out and just want to shoot fireworks all night for some friends and family,
yeah,
you're going to pay about $300-$400 for it.
Well.
That's a lot of money.
That's too much.
Nathan's Famous Hot Dog Eating Contest, that's what it's called, mm-hmm, is held annually on July the 4th. In 2018, champion Joy Chestnut ate 74 hot dogs with buns in just 10 minutes.
She's interesting to watch if you've never watched her.
Joey Chestnut.
Is that not the lady?
Joey, I guess, could it go either way, boy, girl?
I don't know. There was, all I know is there was a female contestant and she just blew my mind.
74 hot dogs.
That's a lot.
Is a lot to put in you. Independence Day became a federal holiday in 1870. As of 2016, July 4th was the number one holiday for beer sales in the United States, according to the National Beer Wholesalers Association.
Wow.
So, all you liquor stores out there, I hope you're prepared for the flux of people you will have on the 4th.
That's why people can eat all those hot dogs. They gotta be liquored up.
So, it's something to worship down
with. Yeah.
Small towns in the U.S. typically spend between $8,000 and $15,000 on their firework displays.
Okay.
You see, I was saying $400 or $500. It seems here, on average, people will spend $8,000 to $15,000 on their firework displays.
Now, I'm not having no 4th parties.
President Calvin Coolidge was born on was born on the 4th of July, 1872. About 16,000 July 4th fireworks displays happen around the country every year, according to the American Pyrotechnics Association.
Okay.
John Hancock has the largest signature on the Declaration of Independence. That's why you hear, give me your John Hancock, when you are, when somebody wants your signature.
Yeah.
And then finally, the last fact, 4th of July fact, is the first July 4th celebration. I mean, come on. I feel like we've read 10 of these when the 4th, when the dates happened. The first July 4th celebration took place at the White House in 1801, hosted by Thomas Jefferson.
Hi.
So there is some July 4th facts for your day. It's a day to celebrate the independence of America and shoot off a few fireworks, barbecue, spend some time with family and friends, and have a good time. It's the summer's holiday.
Well, what do you plan on doing?
That's a good question. I don't have any plans yet. I do not. Again, I feel pressured to have plans, but seeing is that liquor stores are busy on this day. I might need to go work at my store.
Well, yeah, better go get you working shoes on.
That might be something I need to go do, help out. But happy 4th of July to everyone out there, and I hope that you have a great but safe one. But stick with us, ladies and gentlemen. We still have lots more off the cuff coming at you live after these words. We'll be right back.
And I am with the Lex Tropolis magazine, and you are listening to Radio Lex, the voice of the people, WLXU 93.9 LPFM, Lexington, Kentucky.
Are you in the right lane? Should you be? On roads with two lanes going the same direction, the right-hand lane should be used for driving and the left should be used for passing. Vehicles that use the left lane for driving interfere with the natural flow of traffic and create...
Hey, what's going on, Tim?
On roads with multiple lanes going the same direction, the same rules apply. The far left lane should only be used for passing. The slowest moving traffic, including large loads, should use the far right lane. Hi, this is Deborah Hensley with State Farm, reminding you to be a good neighbor and be mindful of your lane when driving and passing.
WLXU 93.9 FM broadcasts live 24/7 from the Deborah Hensley Studio inside the Gray Line Station and Market. Deborah Hensley, State Farm Agent. DeborahHensley.com.
Does it still look crazy out there?
Mm-hmm. Still blue, though.
Everybody to Off the Cuff. Adam Bakes here with you. Amber is also in studio with me. Amber, if you ever turn on the TV, you don't really see the familiar faces that you grew up with. A lot of the, I'll call them legacy talk show hosts, are not on television anymore. Just this year, listen at all of who we lost. Just in 2022, Dr. Oz came to an end in January.
Oh, thank goodness.
Maury Povich will be leaving TV in September of this year. The Doctors was canceled this year. The Real was canceled this year. Judge Jerry was canceled just after three seasons this year. And finally, the Wendy Williams Show was canceled this year after a 14-year run. So that just adds to the amount of legacy talk show hosts that aren't around anymore. And you've got new veterans in there, if you want to call these people veterans. It's sad that we want to call these people veterans, but the newbies in there are Drew Barrymore, Tamron Hall, Kelly Clarkson. Those are kind of your veteran talk show hosts now. So it looks different if you turn on daytime TV.
I'm really digging Drew Barrymore, though. I really am.
Yes. She seems like somebody who is easy to talk to. Mm-hmm. She fits perfectly in that daytime format.
I think it's a good direction for her career to take. I feel like after, you know, she had her Netflix stuff in,
it's nice to see her.
It is. It is nice to see her in another kind of just career. I mean, she's a movie star, no doubt, but being a talk show host, she's really good at it. But the remaining legacy host that we have that still exist, that I guess you could still call legacy host, would be Dr. Phil.
Uh-huh.
He's still on TV. Ryan and Kelly from the Ryan and Kelly Show. But that's it.
Yeah.
Those are your last remaining legacy hosts. You've got people that have been announced that are coming to daytime TV to host. Sherry Shepherd, she was on The View. She's getting her own talk show.
Yeah.
Jennifer Hudson, former American Idol contestant, is getting her own talk show.
Okay.
The star of Queer Eye, Carmero Brown, who was a frequent presence on Maury, is getting his own show with NBC. So a lot of newbies coming into the daytime realm. Daytime TV is so, so important. What daytime does is it creates this adventure of being inside your home every day.
Oh, absolutely.
So these people that host daytime talk shows, they become members of your family.
They do, and you kind of look for them a little bit for your excitement in the day.
You really do. But just talk shows in general, I've always been a fan of, whether it be daytime talk shows, late night talk shows, and we've had conversations about all of those. We went into depth about daytime and late night and the type of talk shows that are out there, Amber. But it made me start thinking of some of my most favorite memorable moments from talk shows just throughout time.
Oh my goodness.
And I have compiled a list here of what I feel like is some of the most memorable talk show moments throughout time.
I am so excited right now.
And Amber, we've got to start the list off when Oprah Winfrey gave everyone in the audience a car.
Oh, goodness.
Can you get more giving than Oprah Winfrey?
No.
There was nobody else in the world like her. There's been nobody still yet on TV that's ever been like Oprah. Ellen tried doing all her little Ellen giveaways.
When
Oprah would do a giveaway on her show,
She did it big.
Uh-huh. And this was one of her most iconic talk show moments in history of her show. And it actually, I feel like, is one of the most iconic talk show moments in general. The time Oprah Winfrey gave a car to everyone in the audience. Let's take a listen. So everybody has a key. Everybody gets a car. You get a car. You get a car. You get a car. You get a car. Everybody gets a car.
I love it.
I mean, so she had it to where she was tricking people. She gave boxes to everybody and she said, okay, now one of you guys will have the key to the new G6, but it's only one of you guys, and then everybody opens their box and everybody's got a key in it.
Oh my goodness, I couldn't imagine.
Because the twist was everybody in the audience was getting a car.
You get a car.
You get a car. Okay, now you can't talk about memorable, iconic talk show moments without bringing up the Jerry Springer Show.
Oh yeah.
One of my most favorite Jerry Springer episodes was an episode he had on pay-per-view. It was called I Married a Horse.
Oh, goodness.
And if you haven't seen it, it is so bizarre. It's so weird. It's hard to find clips from the show. So unable to find clips from the actual episode of the guest that married the show. But here is Jerry Springer talking about that particular iconic moment on the show.
Thank you.
No, it definitely was. It definitely was his wife. And it's hard to find clips, but you can order it or rent it and or buy it on DVD.
You can buy it on DVD?
Well, I know that my dad rented that for me, or he rented it for us to watch back in the day when we were kids.
Oh, okay. Like the old school.
Yeah, remember you could used to rent
yes.
Jerry Springer Too Hot for TV.
Oh, well, we didn't have to rent it. We were on it.
Another memorable talk show moment that has been throughout time was when Magic Johnson talked with Arsenio Hall the day after he announced he was HIV positive. So, you know, when something as huge as that happens, when an announcement like that happens, and somebody just shocks the world, they become the most wanted guest for a talk show.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody wants to talk to that person that just made that groundbreaking announcement.
Yeah.
And Magic Johnson went on his buddy, Arsenio Hall.
Mm-hmm.
He went on his late night show. Now, Arsenio Hall used to have a late night show in the mix with Johnny Carson.
Oh, it was amazing.
Yes. But it got lost in the mix because you had Carson and Letterman. But Arsenio, he was really big in the black community.
Mm-hmm.
And he was really good friends with Magic Johnson. And Magic specifically said he wanted to go on that show. The very next day he announced it to talk about him having HIV. Now think about this, Amber. This was 1991.
Ooh.
Back when HIV was a death sentence. Back when people really didn't know how you got it. People thought that you could get it from sitting on a toilet seat.
Uh-huh.
So the fact that Arsenio Hall invited Magic the day after his announcement to come sit on his couch, shake his hand, hug him, talk to him, was groundbreaking television. Let's take a listen. So, Magic was letting everybody know I had HIV the whole time I was still playing basketball.
Oh, my goodness.
I was doing all these camps, and I was fine. I'm running right now 4 miles a day. So, he was letting everybody know that you can have HIV and still feel fine.
Oh, yeah.
Which is still true today. You can mm-hmm. still have the virus
yes.
and still feel fine, still feel perfectly normal. That's why it's so important to get tested. All right, another memorable talk show moment comes from Dr. Phil, the famous Danielle Bregoli, when she said, "Cash me outside, how about that?" Now, do you know that girl?
Oh, you know I do. Bad Bobby.
This was just a girl who went on a show called Dr. Phil, and she was just this young, troubled teen
uh-huh.
who was always getting in fights, and she reminded you a lot of somebody from where we're from.
Absolutely.
Just getting into fights, just causing trouble, and just causing a lot of pain. And Dr. Phil was interviewing her, and the audience was laughing at the girl, and the girl told the audience to catch her outside.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that, that video went viral, and it just took a life of its own one. I think she had a music deal after this.
Oh, yeah, it still does.
Has a huge social media presence now after this. And it all was because of this iconic moment right here.
Did you say the hoes are laughing?
What I just said.
Well, she meant what she said.
And because of that, seriously, this girl has over like 2 billion followers now.
Oh, yeah.
She's got a record deal. And all because she said, catch me outside, how about that?
How about that?
All right, another memorable talk show moment comes from the Jim Everett versus Jim Rome interview. And the story here is when basically Jim Everett attacks Jim Rome for calling him Chris Everett, which is not his name.
Oh, goodness.
So he keeps calling him by the wrong first name intentionally on purpose, and it just makes him so mad. He gets up and hits him. Let's take a listen.
Oh.
As he attacks him, and the producers start running to save his life. Very memorable moment, definitely worth a YouTube lookup.
Oh my goodness.
And then another here that I would like to share with everybody comes from a Vince McMahon Bob Costas interview. This was from the Bob Costas Show. Bob Costas interviewed many sports figures, and he interviewed Vince McMahon, and Vince McMahon did not like Bob Costas. Always interrupted him because Bob Costas would ask Vince a question, and then when Vince would try to answer, Bob would interrupt him. Don't interrupt Mr. McMahon. He gets upset. Also, it was the line of questioning. He was asking Vince about kids hurting other kids using wrestling moves, and he is bringing up things like distasteful scenes that he would have with women, like making women get on their knees and bark like a dog and things like that. So he was asking Vince to explain himself, and then when he would ask him, he would interrupt Vince. So let's take a listen from Vince McMahon getting pretty heated with Bob Costas. Very, very scary to watch Vince McMahon get mad.
Oh my goodness.
There's more memorable talk show moments that I don't have clips of, but there's the David Letterman black belt scandal when he had an affair on his wife with somebody he worked with, and somebody found out and tried to blackmail David Letterman.
Yeah.
And he went on the late night show and exposed the guy blackmailing him.
Oh.
There was when Johnny Carson helped cause a national toilet paper shortage.
How?
By getting on there and talking, just joking around, saying that there would be a toilet paper shortage if something and something continued.
Oh my goodness.
People believed it because America loved Johnny and listened to everything the man said, so everybody went out and bought toilet paper.
Oh.
And it caused a national shortage.
Well, we've seen that.
Geraldo Rivera, when his nose was broken in a brawl, that might have been the most controversial daytime talk show moment of all time.
Well, I think that was the first time we'd ever seen anybody be, like, physically abused.
Yes, and fight. Yes, it happened in November of 1988. There was the Mark Summers versus Burt Reynolds when Burt Reynolds threw water on Mark Summers. There was the Rosie O'Donnell versus, was it Burt Reynolds when she got somebody on the show and like attacked him for gun control laws?
Oh, I don't know.
Maybe it was somebody else. But there was also the controversial, memorable Geraldo Rivera show when Vince McMahon and a bunch of wrestlers went on there, and they were suing him for sexual harassment, saying there was sexual harassment going on within the company.
Was that the one with the ring announcer?
Yes.
Okay.
There was the Tom Cruise jumping on Oprah's couch.
That was interesting. Interesting.
Acting like a kid in the candy store.
Well, I think that's what Katie Holmes did when their divorce was signed.
But so many memorable talk show moments, Amber. Did I leave any off the list?
Oh, my goodness. I think you hit the big ones. I think, definitely a lot of them come from Jerry Springer. I think he definitely hit us with something we weren't expecting to see. I'm just thinking about, don't take your boot off. When the lady took her shoe off to throw it across stage to hit her friend.
But everybody's got their favorites. Everybody's got the ones that stand out to them. But those are just a few of mine. But ladies and gentlemen, we still have lots more off the cuff coming at you live after these words. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Radio Lex, the community. WLXU 93.9 LPFM, Lexington, Kentucky.
In a media climate where depth and diversity are increasingly hard to find, Radio Lex broadcast independent voices of the community 24/7 in English on 93.9 FM and in Spanish on 95.7 FM. We can't do it without you. Support the voice of the people today. Visit radiolex.us/donate and support Lexington's community radio right now.
Have you been drinking? If so, you shouldn't be behind the wheel. Adults metabolize alcohol at a rate of one drink per hour. If you've been drinking, your judgment is impaired whether you realize it or not. Only time will sober you up. Cold showers and coffee don't do the trick. Every 2 minutes, a person is injured in a drunk driving crash. Drunk drivers account for 10% of all fatal crashes during the day and 30% of all fatal crashes at night. Hi, this is Doug Gleason with State Farm, reminding you to be a good neighbor and to find a designated driver if you've been drinking.
Radio Lex has the support of vinyl sponsors John and Michelle Gardner. Thank you.
Everybody to Off the Cuff. Adam Bates here with you. Amber is also in studio with me. We are very close to the 4th of July, the most patriotic holiday of the year. I love this country. I am proud to be an American. And Amber, a big story happened in this country when Roe versus Wade was overturned. The Supreme Court's decision happened last week to overturn the landmark Roe versus Wade ruling, which guaranteed a constitutional right to abortion. And now, about half of the states have either already banned abortion or indicated that they will soon. Meaning millions of women will no longer have easy access to abortion services. And I have been hearing a plethora of opinions.
Yeah.
And I've been seeing some crazy opinions. I've been hearing and seeing some crazy, just outlandish things from people, which you always get that.
Oh, yeah.
When you have something like this break. I get on Facebook and I see somebody write, well, since everybody has an opinion, here's mine. No, that's not how it works. Just because everybody has an opinion doesn't mean we want to hear yours. I don't want to hear anybody's.
Thank you.
Honestly, I don't care what somebody's opinion is. So I really don't understand why people feel like that their opinion matters, because it don't. When you think that your opinion matters, just know it don't. I miss the days of when the only people that got to speak about their opinion on something were the people who had a platform, like radio host or television host or someone who had a column in a newspaper. Those people could talk about the Roe versus Wade ruling being overturned. But now, thanks to Facebook, everybody has that disgusting platform, that unfiltered platform, and everybody who is anybody from anywhere, from any education, can give us your opinion on the matter. And I've been hearing some crazy, crazy things. So, number one, let me just get this out of the way. If you still, folks, want to go get an abortion, you can absolutely do so in this country. They did not ban abortion. You can still get an abortion. If you want to go abort your baby, good news for you, if you're upset that this ruling was overturned, good news for you, you can still go kill it. You can still go abort it. You're just going to have to put a little bit more gas money in your car. You can't go around the corner and get it done. So before this ruling was overturned, all 50 states were required to perform the abortion because it was legal. It was a constitutional right. But now, they left it up to the states. That's all that's happened. They've left it up to states. And there's been a few states that has said that we're going to ban it. As a matter of fact, there have been 8 states that have banned it. And here are the states that you cannot get an abortion in. That is Kentucky. And since we live in Kentucky, let me tell you what the penalty would be if you do get an abortion. Anyone who provides or attempts to provide an abortion will be charged with a 4 class D felony. The exceptions, guess what, folks? There's exceptions. Did you know that before you got started barking on Facebook about your opinion? The exception of getting an abortion in Kentucky is pregnant person's life is in danger or provider performs medical treatment that accidentally terminates a pregnancy. That's the exception. Other than that, you can't go down the corner and get an abortion. You got to put a little bit more gas money in your car and drive to a state where it's legal. So some more states that have banned it besides Kentucky is Louisiana, South Dakota, Idaho, Tennessee, and Texas. Now, here are some states that plan on banning the abortion in their state. They just haven't done so yet. Arkansas, Mississippi, Missouri, North Dakota, Oklahoma, Utah, Wyoming. But you can still, as of today, folks, go to the following states to get your abortion. You can go to Alaska, abort as many times as you want. You can go to California. You can go to Colorado, Connecticut, Delaware, Hawaii, Illinois, Maryland, Massachusetts, Minnesota, Nevada, New Hampshire, New Jersey, New Mexico, New York, Oregon, Rhode Island, Vermont, Washington, D.C. So what's all this noise of, I can't get an abortion anymore? I think the upset attitude is because it's now not legal in every single state. That, I believe, is where the problem is coming in at. So, if somebody violates these in any states where it is illegal, there will be punishment of some type of fine, felony, and there will be, they'll revoke your medical license if you're the doctor, and you could spend some time in prison for it. So there are still some pretty harsh things set in place. But Amber, what do you make of the news of Roe versus Wade being overturned?
All I'm going to say is, you know, I grew up a very troubled childhood. And I've seen a lot of many things. And as an adult, I carried those things with me. And I'm just going to say I understand that people have circumstances that, you know what, it's just nobody's business. And you guys know that I spend a lot of time working with my weight loss and trying to spread as much positivity as I can to people. So I'll say it just like I said there, because I do have an opinion also. And my opinion is, my opinion should be of no concern to yours. I understand that everybody has the right to feel however they want, and that literally means everybody has the, I guess, the ability to think and feel how they want on particular subjects. And it's not my job nor my place is it to change their opinion, just like I don't want anybody to try to change mine. And my relationship with God is just that, mine. And when I do die and I get to meet my maker, I will not be, I guess, apologizing for other people's transgressions. I will only be apologizing for mine. And I think that's the way it should kind of stay. I think this is something that should not be getting as much, oh, I'm going to hate saying this, but as much, I guess, media as it has been, because we do have so many misinformed people. And all we're seeing right now are wars, online wars, bullying.
Civil wars.
Yeah, so it's just causing more unrest in a time where nobody's resting easy anyways.
I want to read some numbers of just the past year of how many abortions happened in certain states. In 2020, there were 154,060 abortions in California. That's a lot of lives. That's a lot of lives that were aborted in California. Imagine what one of those people could have been. Imagine that. In Colorado, 13,420. Illinois, there was 52,780. This is just within 2020. Maryland, there was 30,750 abortions. Massachusetts, there was 17,060 abortions. That's a lot of people, folks. If you add it all up, that's a pretty huge number. And it makes you think of population control. Could you imagine the population if all these people didn't get aborted and they did live? We'd be a little bit more crowded in this country. But think about how different things could be or would be if these lives lived. And the numbers are substantial and they are huge. And every state that I said with the number beside of it, it's currently still legal. So if you want to go get an abortion, you still have the right in these states to do so. I think here in America, it should all be left up to states. I think that that's how this country should be ran. I think that it should be individualized states that make decisions for a lot of things. Maybe not everything, but a lot of things, yes. Abortion should be one of them. Casino gambling, for instance. You can't do that everywhere, but guess what? Did you know that it's federally, nationally legal to gamble in just across the board in America, but it's left up to the individual state to put it in action?
I did not know that.
And it used to not be like that until like a couple years ago. It was only a few states, Nevada, just a couple.
Yeah.
But then they said, okay, you can do it anywhere in the country, but it's just going to be left up to the state. And here we are so backward in Kentucky, we still have not made that legal. But now they've done the same thing with abortion. They've left it up to states. They do that with a lot of things, folks. They do that with marijuana. Think about how passionate people are with that. Mm-hmm. They leave it up to the state. Gambling, they leave it up to the state. Gay marriage, they used to leave it up to the state.
Yeah.
But 5 or 6 years ago, they made it to where it was your constitutional right to get married in any state.
Yeah.
So it makes you think, will things like that come to the forefront again? Will it go back to being a state choice? A lot of people are concerned. I can see why people are concerned, because Roe versus Wade just kind of happened, I feel like, out of nowhere, this overturn.
No, I don't know. It's always been something that's been on the radar, at least for the last two years. We've been hearing a lot more about it.
Okay. So, yes, a lot of things are left up to states, and I don't think people realize that going into it. I don't think that they realize that. So just know that abortion hasn't been taken away from this country. If you still want to go abort your baby, you can definitely do so. But ladies and gentlemen, we are going to take a little break from that controversial topic and hot topic, and listen to Off the Cuff Song of the Week, and it being the 4th of July this weekend, how about a little patriotic song, Kenny Chesney, American Kids? We'll be back after the song. Mm-hmm.
Sweet Mountain Dew, Top Jacket, or Cherry Coke 10. Mama and Daddy put their roots right here. This is where the car broke down. Yellow dog school bus, kicking up red bus, kicking us up by barbed wire fence. MTV on the RCA, no AC in the vents. We were Jesus, Sammy, Blue Jean, baby, born in the USA.
Alright, on the show thread, Tim Thompson says, what do you guys think about Logan Paul signing with WWE? Well, Tim, Logan Paul, it doesn't surprise me that he signed with WWE. The WWE is a circus these days. It reminds me, I'll compare it to the equivalent of David Arquette signing with the WCW back in the day. It's a circus, so doesn't impress me. I'm not entertained by it, and I honestly don't care what the wrestling industry is doing these days because it's just not how it used to be.
Tell me how you really feel today.
But ladies and gentlemen, we still have one more segment to go, so stick with us. We will be right back after these words.
Some people think they can discontinue insurance on vehicles they only use for part of the year, like motorcycles, RVs, or historic cars. If your vehicle has an active registration, you must carry insurance to cover it. To avoid penalties, turn in your license plate to the county clerk's office before you cancel your policy. Hi, this is Annie with State Farm, reminding you to be a good neighbor. Keep yourself covered and obey Kentucky's auto insurance laws.
Radio Lex has the support of Founders Circle member Lexmark International.
Welcome back, everybody, to Off the Cuff. Adam Banks here with you. Amber is also in studio with me. Last segment of the hour. The NBA draft was last Thursday. We previewed it last week on the show, but since it happened, let's talk about it. The first round consisted of 30 picks, but we'll go over the top five. Orlando Magic drafted Paulio Venturo from Duke. He's the forward, and he's a freshman. And he went number one, not the number one everybody thought it would be. Oklahoma City Thunder drafted Chet Holgerman from Gonzaga, a big forward, a freshman. And the Houston Rockets drafted Jabari Smith Jr. from Auburn, another forward and another freshman. Everybody thought Jabari would be the number one pick. Number four, Sacramento Kings drafted Keegan Murray from Iowa. He is a forward, and he's a sophomore. And finally, the Detroit Pistons drafted Jaden Ivey from Purdue, and he's a guard, and he is a sophomore. The salaries of these first-round draft picks is what always fascinates me, Amber.
Yeah.
That's a lot of money these players make. Do you want to know how much Paulio Venturo, the first-round draft pick, made?
Probably between 3 and 5.
So this is guaranteed money for 2 years. It's 2 or 3 years.
Yeah.
Guaranteed. I believe it's for 3 years. He made
$9,089,300. Ooh.
And the 30th pick in the first round, which is the last first round draft pick, still gets $1.8 million.
Shoot.
And that was Peyton Watson. The last pick in the entire draft, that is first and second round, pick number 58, was the... He went to the Indiana Pacers, and he was from New Zealand, from the New Zealand Breakers. His name is Hugo Besson.
Mm-hmm.
Now, folks are at home probably wondering where the Kentucky players went. There were two in the draft, and yes, those two did get drafted. Shaedon Sharpe, who never put on a Kentucky uniform, but played at Kentucky.
Okay,
because,
sure.
He made $4.9 million in his contract, and he was drafted to the Portland Trailblazers, and then Ty Washington was drafted to the Houston Rockets, and his contract will be $1.8 million, and he'll be playing for the Rockets. But there you go. That, ladies and gentlemen, is the NBA draft and where those players stand.
And look at there, just like that, we're done with sports.
And just like that. So no more sports, Amber, for you. No more sports, no more having to worry about that, so we're gonna have to watch a lot of good movies to have stuff to talk about.
Exactly.
Like, have you seen any good movies lately?
Well, now I went to the movies, but I don't know if I'm gonna say it was a good one.
What'd you see?
I went and watched Black Phone.
I seen the same movie.
Oh.
What'd you think?
Well, you know, I think it would have been an amazing movie if they wouldn't have shown me the entire movie in the trailer.
Right? I hate when movie trailers do that.
You told me too much.
You can do a really good movie and not reveal anything about the plot.
Absolutely.
Or a really good trailer and not reveal anything about the plot in the trailer. Just have teasers in the trailer.
Well, that's what was so disappointing about this, was they didn't hold anything as a teaser. And there were so many things that they could have just give us a little flash and took it away. No, you showed me the whole movie. You told me how the kid, you know, maneuvers through this.
Right, in the trailer it shows the kid loading the phone up with dirt.
Yeah.
So
you know that's happening.
You know that's happening. Uh-huh. And that was a pivotal moment in the movie.
Very. And folks, we didn't break it. We didn't spoiler it for you. They did it themselves.
No. I still want to watch Elvis.
Again, that's on the list.
I still want to watch the new Jurassic Park.
Yep.
I don't know of another summer movie. Nope, I'll give it a try.
Maybe.
No, maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
And there's a movie that I seen from the movie trailers.
Yeah.
Because I love movie trailers. If they don't reveal enough about
all
the movie.
All of it.
But the movie about the tiger that attacks the family going into the safari.
Yes. That one looks good.
It's very Cujo-ish.
And that's all you've done is talk about Cujo for the last, I don't know, 6 months?
I watched it yesterday on Prime.
Did you?
It's still as good as when I first seen it. And what's amazing about the movie Cujo is I met the mom from Cujo.
We met.
I'm pretty sure she was feeling herself that day.
Well, either that or she was trying to flirt with you.
No, she was feeling herself. I don't know. I would flirt back with the mom from E.T.
I thought you were going to say I would flirt with me if I were the mom from E.T.
Well, maybe that too.
That too.
But ladies and gentlemen, that about wraps up another episode of Off the Cuff with Adam Banks. If you like what you heard today, you will probably like what you hear in our archive. So check us out on podcast. We're on Apple Podcasts, we're on Spotify, we are on YouTube, or wherever you can stream your favorite podcast. You can follow the co-host, Amber, on social media at Ambu447. You can follow me, the host, on social media at The Adam Banks. We release new episodes right here on WLXU 93.9 every Thursday from 4 to 5, which means we will be back next Thursday right here from 4 to 5. Ladies and gentlemen, that is Amber Turner. I'm Adam Banks, and this is Off the Cuff. Have a great 4th of July, and we will see you next week.